Hello, welcome again. We are solving some conventional questions of 3D machine. The topic is balancing. Question number 24 from Engineering Services Main 2011 is: a two cylinder uncoupled locomotive has inside cylinder 70 cm apart. The cranks are at right angles and are 0.3 meter long. The mass of revolving parts per cylinder is 160 kg and mass of reciprocating parts per cylinder is 180 kg. The whole of the revolving and 2/3 of the reciprocating parts are to be balanced, and the balance mass are to be placed in the planes of rotation of driving wheels at a radius of 80 cm. The driving wheels are 2 meter diameter and 1.5 meter apart. Find the magnitude and position of the balance masses. The driving crank speed is 300 rpm. So here, so this is 1 and 2 are the planes of crank, and as the crank are at right angle to each other, so this is the, so this is the position of the crank 1 and this is the position of, this is the position of crank. So, and they are 0.7 meter apart, and 3 and 4 are the planes of driving wheel or planes where the BMC mass has to be placed, and so these are 1.5, and these are 1.5 meter apart. Okay. And so theta plane makes an angle theta 3 with the plane 1 and theta 4, and fourth plane makes an angle theta 4 with plane of 1, mass of plane 1. Okay. So now, as it is given that the whole of the rotating and 2/3 of the reciprocating mass have to be balanced, and rotating mass is 160 kg and reciprocating mass is 280 kg, so the total mass which has to be balanced is 280 kg, 180 by 3 into 180. So that is in plane 1. And similarly, the plane mass in plane 2 is 20 kg. And these two masses can be treated as the masses placed at a radius of 0.3 meters for balancing. Okay. So, because the crank radius is 0.3 meters. Okay. Now, these masses has to be balanced by placing masses in plane 3 and plane 4 at radius 0.08 meters, because it is given that the balancing masses have to be placed at a radius 80 cm in the plane of driving. And driving planes in the 3 and 4. So it is R3 and R4 are 0.0. Now let M3 and M4 be the masses placed in plane 3 and 4. So now M1, M2, M3, M4 are placed at radius R1, R2, R3 and R4, and they are in complete balance. Okay. Complete balance means their movement is balanced, forces are balanced, because all will exert centrifugal forces, and due to centrifugal forces there will be movement. Okay. So if you take mass 3, then it will exert m3 r3 omega square centrifugal force, and moment about 4 will be m3 r3 omega square into 1.5. And if we take moment about 4 and take its x component of all the forces, then it will be x component will be m3 r3 cos theta g omega square into 1.5 plus m1 r1 cos theta 1 omega square into 1.5 m1 r1 cos theta 1. Okay. Similarly m cos theta 1 0.75 plus 0.4, that is 1.5. Okay. Similarly m2 r2 cos theta 2, and this distance is 0.4, so m2 r2 cos theta 2 0.4 omega square is equal to 0. Okay. So now speed of the shaft is same for all the masses. Omega can be indicated. So, and theta one is your 0 angle of 1 with respect to the itself is 0. So cos theta 1 is your 1. So theta 2 is your 90. So cos theta 2 is your 90. Okay. So cos theta 2 will be your 0. So now we have only this term m3 r3 cos theta 3 into 1.5 plus this term. This term is 0. So from this we have m3 cos theta 3 is equal to -770, and similarly y component can be found by taking sine component of this, sine theta 3, sine theta 1 and sine theta 3. All other things are same. And as theta 2 is 90 and theta 1 is 0, so this will be 0 and this will be m2 r2 0.4. So from this we can find out m3 sin theta 3, that is -280. So this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. From 1 and 2 we can find out scaling adding 1 and 2 we can find out this 819 and 3 as 819.3 and by dividing the two we can find out angle because sine is in negative force, negative and tangent is positive, so this is in third quadrant. Okay, so whatever the value of tangent comes out from by dividing 280 by 270 will add 182, so it will be 119.9. So the mass m3 is 819.32 and its location is 19 is at angle theta 3, that is 119.9. Okay, now we have to find out mass m4. To find out mass m4 we will balance the forces. So x component forces are we are already neglecting omega square. So in x direction, m1 r1 omega square is the force, and here this is only in y direction, so it will not be taken, and its cos component will give the force in x direction, and its cos component will give the force in x direction. So it will be its value, the force, the value of this force is m4 r4 omega square, and value of this force is m3 r3 omega square, and cos component will give horizontal component. So now taking the horizontal component, so m1 r1 plus m3 r3 cos 199.98 because theta 3 199.98 and m4 r4 cos theta 4. Okay, now we have m3, we have r3, okay, and we have this theta 3 also. So now we can find out m4 cos theta 4 by putting this value. M1 and r1 we have. Okay. So m4 cos theta 4 comes out minus 282.817. Now we take sine component, then we'll take m2 r2 here because m1 r1 doesn't have any y component, so m2 r2 is vertical force. We are neglecting omega square, we are uniting omega square. So m2 r2 will have a y component, and similarly the sine component of this will be the y component. Here we'll take sine, here we'll take sine. So from this we can find out m4 0.08 sine theta 4, that will be m4 sine theta 4 is equal to minus 770. This is your equation number 4 and this is equation number 3. So if we scale and add them, then we can find out m4. So m4 is 820.32, and if we divide them, then we find out theta 4. As this here also the sine is negative, force is negative, tangent is positive. So it is your third quadrant. So here we get the value of theta 4 as you calculate the value of theta is 70 point something. So we add 182, then we get the original angle, that is 70.016. So answer is m4 is 820.32 kg. Okay, that is more than that is kg, and angle is this is kg, and angle is 250.01.